morning, LHS. Today is May 11th, 2018. I'm Jake Richards.
I'm Alex Ramos.
And this is Gail Zarat. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Last Friday, our FFA members attended a state convention. Jordan Ash won an award for a gold-rated treasure book.
Students and staff, please check your LCS school Gmails to see if you got chosen to take a survey. Survey results will remain anonymous, but will help our AP students with their final project.
Hi, I'm Mr. Stedman. I teach AP Government here at Lancaster High School.
I'm in AP English.
I'm currently in AP English 11 and AP Government.
I'm taking three of the physics tests, two of the economics tests, the second calculus, the second English, and stats. I think that's all of them.
I'm in AP Government.
Well, you know, throughout the year, I think we've gone through, we have, you know, covered obviously all the material that we need to cover, being aware of the various test questions, the kinds of test questions that the AP likes to answer, getting comfortable with answering those types of questions.
We've had CRAM sessions. We've also had a few in-class essays. She's had us read over, you know, students' past essays for the AP test and critique them. That's about it.
In class, we did a lot of answering of the old AP questions and seeing how well we did. A lot of the tests that we took were geared towards the AP, and we just did a whole lot of refreshers and small practices every day, as well as studying on my own.
Well, what we've done, we've had CRAM sessions like this past Friday. We had one for AP Government with Stedman. It really just a bunch of tests and all that. We went over some previous AP questions.
I would definitely say yes, my students are prepared for the test.
I think the tests are going to go very well for not just me, but for everyone. We've done a great job this year of preparing, and I can't wait to see the results.
I think I'm pretty prepared. I feel like both of my teachers did a really good job at doing so. I know that I'm a little nervous for all the writing on the English exam, but I think overall I will do pretty well, at least get a 3.
It really depends, because you never really know what's going to be on the test, but I'd say I'm pretty good.
Well, it's a pops concert, so there's lots of pop songs that you'll know. They're a lot of fun. Some of the songs are Hey Jude by the Beatles, Believer by Imagine Dragons, Africa by Toto. Our men's ensemble are singing Sweet Caroline and The Lion Sleeps Tonight, and then Dancing Queen by one of the women's ensembles. And there'll be lots of solos by the seniors. Tickets are $3, and they're available at lunch. Practice a lot, and we try to add in some choreography to add some interest to the concert at the end of the year. The concert is May 22nd at the high school in Lancaster High School Auditorium.
Congratulations to the baseball team for winning their first OCC championship in school history. And also congratulations to the softball team for winning an OCC championship.
The softball team keeps breaking records and recently broke 45 home runs in a season.
This group of seniors have had an impressive 4 years. Congratulations to both baseball and softball, and keep it going in the tournaments.
So my favorite moment so far this season is when Ashley and I got pulled from the Logan game. It was a doubleheader, and we were in here going crazy. We're pretty entertaining if you don't know us, so we were making Snively and Miller have a good time in here. So
my favorite moment is definitely sweeping Pick Central, because we haven't done that in the past 3 years, so it was really nice to do it my last year.
You make time for the things you want.
I think one sentence statement I would say is probably, Snively says make it happen all the time. And I think it's really good, because no matter what happens, you get injured, you have a bad at bat, you just have to try to make it happen and work hard for that in softball and in life.
Hers is really meaningful. Mine's 10 out of 10, would play again. Definitely recommend to other softball players.
Intense, and Miller can sometimes be the calm part of it.
Yeah, they balance each other out with their different coaching styles. They definitely balance each other out.
Miller, did you make these questions?
Yeah, I did.
What do you expect us to say to that?
I really wanted to.
Lexi Matheny.
Yeah.
She forgets everything.
Lexi Matheny is.
Yeah, I would say me, because I don't even have my BP jacket on. I forgot it, so.
My favorite break is when, right before warm-up, right before we're about to go and take infield, we say get your pee hot on three. It's just trying to get us like in the mood, get us pumped up and ready for the game.
Friday, May 11th brings us to a little less than 3 weeks left in school. In these 3 weeks, there's a lot packed in, starting with the percussion ensemble tonight and Saturday at 8 o'clock. Next week, we have our class award ceremonies in the mornings with 11th graders on Monday, 10th on Tuesday, 9th on Wednesday, and seniors on Thursday, where we'll also be on activity period. Thursday, 17th, we have a band concert, and Tuesday, the 22nd, a choir concert, both starting at 7 o'clock. Seniors, your finals are Tuesday the 22nd and Wednesday the 23rd. You also have graduation practice on Friday the 25th at 9 a.m. We're off school for Memorial Day on Monday the 28th with finals for 9th through 11th graders on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, the last day of school. Seniors, you have 6 days of school left, 2 days of finals, and 16 days until graduation on Sunday the 27th. Where you wear one of these. Make these last 2 weeks of your school careers count. End this year with some positive momentum to carry on into your futures in the college, military, or workforce. Here's hoping to an outstanding careers for all of you. Thanks so much for what you've done for Gale Pride in this building and this community this school year. As you go on about your adult lives, never forget where you came from and what is made possible on hashtag Granville Pike.
And have a great Friday, LHS.
And as always, go Gales.
Guys, I'm the closer.
Why'd you put Matt on me?
And this has been Gale's Wrap.
Have a nice weekend, LHS.